Yo, this is Ross, and today we're going to be looking at persimmons. This is a nice little persimmon update for you guys in the spring. Maybe this will answer some questions I've been getting recently about persimmons. This is my Rosianca. This is a four-year-old tree, believe it or not. It's been doing really well. This is now its fourth spring, like I said, and this is an American Asian hybrid. This is combining the flavor of an Asian persimmon. It's also astringent, by the way, I want to mention that. Combined with the hardiness of an American persimmon, it just does really well here in my zone 7A climate here in Philadelphia. I've seen no dieback, and the tree's just done well from the very start. All I needed to do was really stake this thing up with a nice stake here, a nice little T-post. This has been key, guys, because this has been in a really windy area, and it's actually quite a lanky tree, and preventing all that lankiness and staking it up is really going to get you yourself a healthier tree quicker. This tree actually 2 years ago had fallen over completely on the ground in a freak storm. From that point on, I realized that this is just a windy area of my property, and taking those steps from that point. But the persimmon this year, finally, in its fourth spring, has flowered, is gonna fruit for me. You can see some of that fruit up in here. You can see this is the remnant of the flower, and underneath the flower is indeed that fruit. You can see some of it, some of them have actually already dropped off right there. So I'm anticipating, in fact, some of them already have, I'm anticipating that some of the flowers, some of the fruits are gonna drop off, but I would say because Rosianca is not really the biggest persimmon, you know, it's more of like a larger American in terms of size. I would say we're gonna get about 200 fruits off of this tree alone, which is real exciting because I absolutely love persimmons, guys. You really should get one if you don't have one already. And this thing is putting out flowers on the, here's a common question I get. If your tree hasn't flowered by now, on this new growth, on about the, maybe by the fifth or sixth leaf that comes out of the old wood here. So we've got a number of leaves now from this particular branch, but I would say about from this point here, this section here, if it doesn't flower from here onwards, it's just not going to. So it puts out those flowers on the new growth from last year's wood, very similar to a mulberry, and it does it very early in the season. So if you were hoping for fruit and it hasn't done this already, well, you may be a bit out of luck this year. Here's a nice little cluster of fruits, believe it or not. I'm counting, I think, one, that one's dropped off. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Eight fruits in just this little area of the tree. They're just so productive. In fact, I might have to take off some fruits. That's a very common thing with persimmons, is that they fruit so heavily that a lot of the limbs break. So we're gonna keep an eye on this tree, but for now it's just looking beautiful. And there is some decent weirdness here with the foliage. And this happens, I think, every year, is that a certain time of the year, some pest comes in and kind of messes with these leaves. You can see a nice little perfect, you know, stunning, pristine leaf, and then you've got the tips of them just not looking too good. So, you know, I'm sure nature and the ecosystem here is gonna kind of fix that for me. I'm not gonna pay too much attention to it, but maybe next year I'll spray it with some kind of dormant oil and maybe this won't happen for me. But that's kind of it, guys. That's really the big update on this tree. Not a whole lot going on with it. Not a whole lot of care. I haven't had to water it. Trying to take away fertility is gonna help this thing grow less and fruit more. So I'm trying to actually take away a lot of that soil that we've been building up over the years. It's actually really fertile underneath that tree. There's at least 3 inches of topsoil, 3 inches of compost that we have created with all kinds of worm castings and worms in it. So the goal now, I think now that we're at a huge size, is actually to really slow down the growth and get this thing to fruit a bit more heavily in the future. But I'm gonna be enjoying lots of persimmons this winter time, and then in this fall, we're gonna dry a lot of them. You know, what am I gonna do with 200 persimmons? I would love to have that problem. So, all right guys, we're gonna keep you guys updated on what the fruit looks like as we progress through the season and also the harvest. So stay tuned for that, and we'll see you for tomorrow's video. All right guys, take care, and I'll catch you later.